tell me about the Sea City Brothers. What was the inspiration for getting the group together?
Yeah, this is just something exciting. We've sort of been toying with for a couple of years now. Thought we'd get the best singers in the team together and come up with a band and try and write a song and release it, you know. So, rugby doesn't last forever for us, obviously. You know, we can only sort of play sort of into your early 30s, and you've got to start looking at life after rugby, and this seemed like a really, really cool avenue to start exploring.
Did you guys hold any sort of auditions within the team to find the five best singers for the group?
Yeah, we did, kind of. You know, Andy got together and we went around the team and, you know, we had some auditions, got the boys to sing a little tune that they thought of, and, you know, these five members
you came through,
sung the best. As as Andy, or, you know, Stan Walker would say, Andy was in awe of us, so we've done pretty well.
Oh, look, the way these guys sing, and you'll hear, because the single's coming out soon, it really is, it's quite special. You know, it was sad having to turn down the likes of White Crockett, Luke Romano, from the audition list. Even George Whitelock, who's got a really nice deep baritone sort of voice, just couldn't make it through that sort of second audition.
Because I notice you're all backs, you know, are the forwards jealous of you guys?
I think they probably are a little bit, but I think the most rewarding thing for us has just been as individual artists coming together and collaborating as a group, and we're really proud of the product that we've been able to put together, so it's been really enjoyable.
Tell me about the inspirations. T, how about you? Who's the musical inspiration for you and the Sea City Brothers?
For me, growing up, especially a couple, Elvis is one of them, bit of Sam Cooke in there. But we were just, like Willi said, it was good getting together and just intertwining our voice together as one and coming out as Sea City Brothers. So.
Now, Robbie, tell me, you've got a great bit of rapping going on in the middle of the song. Have you been out on the streets rapping, you know, have you been in that scene for a long time?
Yeah, you know, I grew up in one of those areas where we just, you know, you were just brought up around rap and things like that, but I was also more around, you know, I was inspired by guys like, you know, Boyz II Men, Temptations, you know, group bands. So, you know, it was awesome. It was awesome to know that we were going to come together as a group, and couldn't wait to get our harmonies together. So it was awesome.
Dreams and aspirations for the group and for the song. What do you hope is going to happen?
Yeah, well, you know, obviously with it going onto iTunes and us creating a music video, that should be out in the next week or so. You know, there will be funds generated, obviously, out of it. We're looking to give 100% of those funds to charity. Cystic Fibrosis, the Crusaders rugby team has had a long association with them. They're a great charity and do wonderful things in the community. So along with Jace Kirsten, who I've talked to about it, you know, we've decided that we'd love to give all the proceeds to that wonderful charity.
Sea City Brothers.
We're modest and we don't want to sort of talk ourselves up too much, but look, what we've got is something bloody exciting, really is. Hi, we're the
Sea City Brothers.